Let us look at the problem 7. A train was moving with a velocity of 90 km per hour when brakes were applied. The acceleration was reduced to minus 1 meter per square second. Calculate the distance covered by the train before coming to rest. In this problem, we have to find the distance covered by the train before coming to rest. So in this problem, a train was moving with velocity, moving velocity means it is initial velocity. U is given 90 km per hour. When brakes were applied by, the acceleration was reduced to, and acceleration reduced to minus 1 meter per square second. So acceleration is minus 1 meter per square second. Calculate the distance. We have to find the distance by the train before coming to rest. So train is moving with 90. When brakes were applied by the acceleration, the train was reduced to minus 1 meter per square second when brake applied. So after a certain time it comes at rest, so its final velocity become 0. So we know that we have equation v square equal to u square plus 2as. So using this formula we can get the value of s, because we have v value of u, a, and we get the value of s. But in given, initial velocity is given in kilometer per hour, but in numerical we have to change the unit in SI unit. Like initial velocity, and velocity is always in meter per second because its unit is meter per second. So in this problem there is 90 km per hour. So first of all we have to change in meter per second. So it become 1000, then per minute divide in 1 hour, we have 60 into 60 decimal second. When we solve this, we get the value that is 25 meter per second. This is the initial velocity. So v is 0, 0 square means 0. U is 25 square and 2, and a is given minus 1. We have to find the, yes, 0 square means 0, 25 square means 625 plus minus 2, yes. Then 2 years equal to 625. When this minus 2 come this side, then it become plus 2 years, then years equal to 625 divide 2. When we solve it, we get the value 312.5, and the unit of distance is meter. So this is the required distance. Let us look at the next problem, problem number 8. A car moving with 30 meter per second is stopped at a distance of 20 meter. Calculate the time required to stop it. So in this problem, a car is moving with 30 meter per second, moving with, so it is initial velocity. So we know initial velocity u is 30 meter per second, is stopped at a distance of 20 meter. So distance is given 20 meter. Calculate the time required to stop it. Calculate the time. We have to find the time. But when a car is moving with 30 meter per second, is stopped at a distance of 20 meters. So its initial velocity is given, but after a certain time when it is stopped, then its final velocity become zero. And we know that acceleration is given by v minus u by t, and we have to find the t. We have to find the value of t, but we have initial velocity. This initial velocity and v is also given, but we don't have acceleration. So first of all, we have given distance. First of all, we have equation s equal to ut plus half a t square and v square equal to u square plus 2as. This is the two equations of the motion. By using this equation, we can solve the value of the t, and we get the value of the a also. But in this, we use v square equal to u square plus 2as, because we have v, u and s, then we can easily find a. When we find the value of a, then when we put the value of a here, then we get easily the value of t. So v is given 0 and u is given 30 square plus 2 into acceleration. We have to find the acceleration, and distance is given 20. 0 square means 0, 30 square means 900 plus 40 a. Then when we solve this equation, then it comes 900 equal to 40 a. Then again, next step is 900 divide 40 equal to a. Therefore, we get the value minus 22.5. This is the acceleration, and we know that the unit of acceleration is meter per square second, but we need now. We have acceleration equal to v minus u by t. Then we have value, acceleration value is 22.5, and v is given 0, u is 30. v is 0, u is 30, and we have to calculate the value of time just by doing cross multiplication. We get minus 22.5 into t equal to minus 30. Then t equal to minus 30 divide minus 22.5. Then the value of t become 1.33 second, because the unit of time is second. So this is the required time.